Welcome to this spoken tutorial on batch import of items. In this tutorial, we will learn to set up SAF builder, create a simple archive format, and do a batch import of items into a collection. This tutorial is recorded using Ubuntu Linux OS 18.04, DSpace version 6.3, Firefox web browser, and Gedit text editor. However, you may use any other web browser and text editor of your choice. To practice this tutorial, you should have a working internet connection, installed DSpace 6.3 on your system, Tomcat service should be running, have administrator's authority in DSpace, and created a collection in the community. If not, then please go through the prerequisite tutorials on this website. To follow this tutorial, you should have knowledge of library science and familiarity with Dublin Core metadata standards. The files used in this tutorial are available in the code files link on this tutorial page. Please download and extract the files before practicing. Batch import feature facilitates the upload of a large number of items simultaneously. DSpace administrator is authorized to use the batch import feature. Items uploaded using batch import are directly archived. Basically, metadata for each item is entered in a spreadsheet along with the file name. Then, we have to compress the spreadsheet and item files into a zip file using SAF builder. Using administrator authority, we have to upload the zip file. To import a batch of items, DSpace requires items in the simple archive format, that is SAF. SAF builder is the tool that is used to create the simple archive format. SAF builder is an add-on tool which can be set up for any Ubuntu Linux user. The manual to set up SAF builder on Windows is provided as additional reading material on this tutorial page. Let us see the structure for simple archive format. The archive contains one subdirectory per item. Each subdirectory contains dublincore.xml file, that is the item's metadata, files that come along with the item, and the contents file, which consists of a list of file names. Let us proceed to set up the SAF builder tool. Open the terminal by pressing Ctrl, Alt and T keys simultaneously on the keyboard. Ensure that you have root permissions to run the commands. Here onwards, please press the Enter key after typing each command. I will set up the SAF builder tool on the user spoken on my machine. Git, JDK and Maven tools are used to download and compile SAF builder respectively. These are already installed during DSpace installation. Type the following command to download SAF builder from DSpace-labs repository in GitHub. The SAF builder download may take some time depending on your internet speed. If the SAF builder download fails, then recheck your internet connection or try after some time. SAF builder download is now completed on my machine. Now type cd SAF builder to change the current directory to SAF builder directory. Then type /safbuilder.sh to compile SAF builder. Compilation of SAF builder has started and it may take some time to complete. If SAF builder compilation fails, then recheck your internet connection or try after some time. The SAF Builder compilation is now successful. Next, let us proceed to create a simple archive format of different items. Type cd $home to change the current directory to home directory. Now, let us create a directory to store the metadata spreadsheet and all the files to be uploaded. I will create a directory named item upload. To do so, type mkdir item upload. I have downloaded an article and its metadata files in my downloads folder. These are provided in the code files link. Using cd command, we will switch to the downloads directory. Type ls to check the contents. For this demonstration, we will use article1.pdf and article2.pdf files for the batch upload. So copy the files article1.pdf and article2.pdf to item upload directory with this command. Now, let us proceed to check the metadata spreadsheet file. Right-click on article1-2 metadata.csv and select Open with LibreOffice Calc as shown here. The text import dialog box appears, which have some settings in which to import the text. Keep the default settings and click on the OK button. Article1-2 metadata.csv opens as a spreadsheet. Observe that the first row is the header row. Each column of the header row is a Dublin code element. It corresponds to each field in the item submission form. It is mandatory to use header names strictly as provided in this metadata spreadsheet. The first column is file name, which is used to write the name of the file to be uploaded. The next columns sequentially represent each field in the item submission form. For example, the first field in the item submission form is authors. The corresponding column for author in the spreadsheet is dc.contributor.author. Author is a multi-value field in item submission form. So multiple columns are represented as dc.contributor.author. The number of columns can be added or removed from multi-value fields in the item submission form. Similarly, we have columns for other fields in the item submission form. Single-value fields in the item submission form are represented using a single column. Multi-value fields in the item submission form are represented using multiple columns. Each row in the spreadsheet represents a separate item. For each item to be uploaded, write the file name and metadata as shown. The metadata spreadsheet should be saved in CSV format only. Close the Calc window now. Switch back to the terminal. Now, copy the metadata spreadsheet file to the item upload directory. To do so, type the command as shown here. Now, let us check the contents of the item upload directory. Using cd command, change current working directory to the item upload directory. Then type ls. Item upload directory has the files to be uploaded and their metadata in a CSV file. That is, article1.pdf, article2.pdf, and article1-2 metadata.csv. Now let us proceed to create a zip file in the SAF format. Type this command to change the present working directory to SAF Builder. Type the next command as shown to prepare a simple archive file. The simple archive file creation is successful. The simple archive file in zip format will be created in the directory of the metadata spreadsheet. In our case, it is item upload. Type this command to change the current directory to item upload directory. Type the command ls to get a list of files in item upload directory. Simple archive format.zip is seen here. Now, let us proceed to upload the zip file for batch import in DSpace. Open the DSpace interface. Log into DSpace with your administrator authority. I will log in with my administrator authority. Click on the Logged In tab at the top right corner. Select Administrator from the drop-down. Click on the Content tab in the navigation bar. From the drop-down, select Batch Import. The Batch Import page opens. Select type of the input data. Simple archive format, zip file via upload is selected by default. To upload the SAF zip file, click on the Browse button in the Select Data File to Upload field. The File Upload dialog box opens up. Browse and select the file simplearchiveformat.zip. Then click on the Open button. On success, the name of the file is displayed next to the Browse button. Click on Select the Owning Collection of the Items drop-down. From the list, select the collection into which we want to upload the items. I will select Articles. Select Other Collections that the items will belong to field appears above the Upload button. For this demonstration, I am not selecting any other collection. Click on the Upload button at the bottom of the page. A message is displayed. The job was taken over. An email will be sent as soon as it is finished. We can see the progress of the batch import in the My DSpace page. Click on My DSpace link. In the batch import section, we can see the timestamp of the job submission for the batch import. Also, we can see the success status for this batch import job. To view more details, click on Show More link next to the timestamp of the job submission. Items to be imported and items imported along with the number of items is displayed. To view the imported items, click on the link Show Items next to the label Items Imported. Map file contains mapping of items uploaded in the batch and their handle numbers. Download the map file by clicking on the Download Map File button below the label Items Imported. We can also delete the items that were uploaded using batch import. To do so, use the button Delete Uploaded Items and Remove Import next to Download Map File button. For this demonstration, I will not be deleting the items imported as a batch. Now, let us cross-verify the batch import of the items in the collection. To do so, click the Browse tab in the navigation bar. Then click on Communities and Collections from the drop-down. Select the Articles collection. The collection homepage appears. Scroll down to locate the items we imported in the collection. We can see that the items submitted using batch import are successfully uploaded here. Sometimes, items uploaded in a batch may take some time to appear in the collection. Select the first item submitted using batch import. We can see the metadata of the item and its file. This means we have successfully uploaded items using SAF Builder and Batch Import. On success of the Batch Import job, an email notification is also sent to the administrator. Let us proceed to cross-verify the email notification. Login to your administrator's email account. This is my administrator's email account. Here is the mail with the subject DSpace, batch import successfully completed. If the email is not seen in the inbox, then it could be in the spam folder. Otherwise, please recheck your internet connection. Let us open the email. The email contains a map file path. So now, we have verified the email notification of successful completion of batch import. Switch back to DSpace. Let us log out from the DSpace interface. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned to set up SAF Builder, create simple archive format, and do a batch import of items into a collection. As an assignment, create a metadata spreadsheet for article3.pdf and article4.pdf. Use metadata provided in the code files for article3.pdf and article4.pdf. Upload article3.pdf and article4.pdf in article collection using batch import. The video at the following link summarizes the spoken tutorial project. Please download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops and gives certificates. For more details, please write to us. Please post your timed queries in this forum. Spoken Tutorial Project is funded by MHRD, Government of India. DSpace Spoken Tutorial Series is funded by the National Virtual Library of India, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. This script and the video for this tutorial was contributed by Pankaj Patil from IIT Bombay. And this is Nancy Verkey signing off. Thanks for joining.